Hey guys, it's Chris from Steeda. We have Jamie here, our head tech at our Valdosta facility, as well as our in-house autocross driver. We have the Steeda GT350. Really excited to get out to an SCCA National Tour event right here in Moultrie, hosted by the Red Hills region. What have you done to this car to get it ready for this weekend?
Well, this car's got our dual rate springs, front and rear, sway bars, stop the hop kit, the bushing support kit, IRS braces, alignment kit, and it's got a performance alignment on it for autocross. And other than the H pipe to give it a little bit more sound, the car's completely stock. This car isn't even tuned. It's still got stock tune on it.
Right, and we don't intend to tune it either. But all in all, it's going to be interesting to see how this thing does. In preparation for this autocross event, we have had a few events where we've taken this car out to get a feel for it on those Falcon RT660 tires, as well as the Hawk DTC60 brake pads up front. Never driven this car with those brake pads in an autocross setting. Been driving on it for the past week just around the street to get things kind of bedded in and seated in correctly for the event. I'm told they're quite dusty but quite effective, so we'll see how it goes. But outside of that, you ready to get racing, Jamie?
Yeah, we're ready to go.
All right, let's do it. Recap of day one. It's been a long day here. We had our cars and coffee this morning at Steeda, raced over here to Moultrie for this Red Hills region SCCA National Tour event. Jamie and I just finished. It's been crazy. Unfortunately, we weren't able to get first place for today, but we still got tomorrow. Very, very fast car in first place, driven by Randy Adkins. It's a 2016 GT350 with all kinds of crazy parts on it, and including our Steeda K member, right, Jamie?
Yeah, it's got our Steeda K member. I put it in several months ago.
A little bit lighter, wider tires.
A little more
brakes,
power.
A little bit more power, some aero. But anyways, we're doing everything we can to keep up. My best today was a 49.29. Jamie was right behind in a 51.0. And needless to say, we'll see tomorrow what turns out. I mean, it'll be our best run from the day and our best run from tomorrow added together to see, well, how everyone places at the end of the day. So, what do you think about tomorrow? You ready?
As long as we don't spin or hit any cones, we should be in pretty good shape. I mean, we've split the GT350 between its owner and its co-driver, so I think we're doing pretty good there. We just need to clean up a few things and improve on what we did today.
All right, well, we'll see you guys tomorrow, and hopefully we'll be having some better news for you. End of a long weekend here, SCCA National Tour event here in Moultrie, Georgia. Big, huge thanks to the Red Hills region locally for hosting this. Jamie, how do you think it went this weekend?
The event went off really well. The weather was great. The attendance was good. 121 entrants. So pretty good event for the end of the year. A lot of people travel out of town to come to this event. Everything ran well, no incidents. It was just a good event.
For sure, for sure. And in Cam C, we had 5 cars total. Now the course today, now in your opinion, how do you think the course felt today versus yesterday?
Yesterday's course was super technical in comparison. Today's course was more open. There were some places that were technical that you had to get your head around what to do with the car because of the speed. Today's course was a lot higher speed than yesterday.
Definitely helps out these high horsepower Mustangs a little bit more.
The high horsepower cars definitely benefited today over the run-of-the-mill Mazda Miata.
Absolute blast this weekend. Randy Adkins driving the absolutely stunning blue 2016 GT350 with a ton of parts on it. Absolutely awesome driver, awesome owner as well. We had a chance to talk with him. He ran a 46.9 today with a total time of 94.9 between both days. I ended up with a 48.1 today and a 97.4 with the second place trophy. James, the owner of that blue GT350, ended up with a 46.8 today, 99.1 total. And Jamie, number 4, 48.5 with a total of 99.5. I mean, just between today and yesterday, you're driving in a car that you don't even own. I mean, significantly improved.
Yeah, started getting a little bit more comfortable with the car. We made some changes during the course of the day that really helped the car settle in. It was a little nervous yesterday, yeah. a little just, it didn't feel quite balanced, and we made changes to it today that really helped improve it. It was a lot better today, a lot easier to drive.
And to be completely honest, no parts changes. It was simply tire pressure and getting used to the car, getting seat time with the car, because at the end of the day, the more seat time you can get with these cars, the better. I mean, obviously, a big difference between today and yesterday, and even myself too. Today felt way better than yesterday.
Getting the tire pressures up for the speed of the course helped today. It just helped complete the car. Made the car feel better, it was more comfortable, it was more consistent. It was more consistent at the start of the run, at the end of the run, than it was yesterday.
And to speak to the brakes, this is my first event running the DTC 60 pads up front on this car. I've done 5 or 6 events with this car already. Huge difference, absolutely huge difference. It was kind of crazy to see Jamie running out on track and actually spitting some sparks and fire out of the front wheel wells coming into the finish, and a couple of those hard braking zones out there. But needless to say, what do you think? Take this thing out again, get the EcoBoost ready to go. What's next?
We got a lot of decisions to make at what we're going to do first of the year. There's the first two Southeast Division national events for Autocross, February. There is going to be a Pro Solo at the firm, and then in March, we'll be back at another national tour at South Georgia Motorsport Park. We've got a lot of decisions to make on which way we're gonna go with this.
So with that said, go ahead and comment below. Let us know what you wanna see more of. Do you want us to add any parts to this thing? You want us to do some more stuff with the EcoBoost? Maybe some more testing, you name it, we wanna see it. Go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button, that notification bell, so you get a notification on your phone next time a Steeda video drops. And don't forget the most important thing.
Speed matters.